Hello, this is Dimitri with UKidsToys.com, and we're going to be looking and assembling the new model, which is a combination lock. It's in front of you right here. So we're going to see how long it's going to take us, how fast of the assembly is going to be. Supposedly a little bit under an hour, plus minus, but we'll check. This is the first time I'm looking at it, first time I'm assembling it. So it's a nice looking combination lock inspired by Da Vinci Code. So let's see what we can make out of it. Just a regular opening process. Nothing special here. And, let's see. So we got about two boards on here. Everything looks very simple. I don't think there is going to be any complication to the assembly of this particular unit. So you got one board here and a second board here with some toothpicks packed in a separate nice little pouch. So we're gonna go ahead and start with the instructions. Little warning signs and understanding of certain things. The use of the sandpaper is recommended just to grind out the connection portions. Obviously a little knife or a scalpel or a box knife to get the toothpicks cut. And obviously if there is an exclamation point, you need to make sure that you follow the directions exactly. One more detail and thing about it, we use the toothpicks, just a regular toothpicks that you can get in any grocery store or just any generic brand made in China. They will all work. If the toothpick does not go very easy, just get another one, use a new one, and it should slide right in. Everything has tolerances and everything will be assembled per the visual pictures. So we're gonna go ahead and start with the first part. This is, we're looking at the first board. There is two portions right here. So we're gonna push them out. You got a front surface, you got a back surface, and then so you push it towards the front in order to get a nice and clean look and eliminate any kind of fiber pools on the front surface that you're gonna be showing off to people. So this is the first portion, kind of work it back and forth to see if it comes out nice. Push it, pull it, and then this piece number four, I'm gonna push the whole block out, put the boards aside and get it out of the block. Once again, if with these smaller pieces, you gotta be a little bit easier on the piece itself, but the board itself, I mean, as you can see probably on the video, it's cracking, so it shouldn't be a big deal. Now just pull the part out. We got that. So we have number four piece and gets inserted into number two, just like this. Push it up forward, and then so it should look like this. And then you use number three piece with the these marks on one side towards the that lock looking thing, and then insert these two together. Should make nice assembly, just like this. So that's what you're gonna have it look like. Then we need to push parts number eight from the board. Looks like little keyways. Got four of these, and they go onto that little assembly that you just made. with the locks facing outward, and just put four of them in each of the allocated holes. They just go like this. Just four of them with assembly. So have disassembled, just a little check mark here, we're all good to go. So going to the next page, we do need, looks like pretty much all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, let's see, all of these on the bottom, one of these, and two of these. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 total. So we're gonna push them out once again. It's all number ones. Let's see, two of these on this side. We got all of them out. This little internal piece, I'm actually gonna push it from the other side in order to not to have any fibers pulled out. Just a little pressure and should be able to take everything out and what you need to take out. Shouldn't be putting too much pressure in there, because otherwise you're risking of breaking some pieces. And now we come to the use of the toothpicks. Get it in here. We'll start with the first one, and I think any random unit will be okay. Does say pre-cut the little point, is just to make sure that we don't cut ourselves. Got my little knife here. I'm gonna cut off the sharp ends. And it's, we need four toothpicks. So I got four of these prepared. I'm gonna enter it from one side. And a suggestion not to push onto the toothpick, just use your fingers to push them through, because if you push it, you're risking of hurting yourself. So I'm just gonna use my workbench in order to pull them further. And then we're just gonna go ahead and assemble all of them on a workbench. So we got just four pressure points, push them down. Every single piece should go in pretty easy. The holes are big enough for the toothpicks not to break. And two. Three. Four. Five, six, seven, eight. So now you guys know that I can count up to eight. We have four toothpicks sticking out here. It is recommended to use the sandpaper and the cut them off. So I'm not gonna use the sandpaper at this time. I'm just gonna slice them off very nice to make sure they're completely off with the box cutter. So we have nice smooth connection points right here. Go to the next page. And we do have the assemblies. You gotta push it in a little bit. And let's see, doesn't look like it matters which side you insert it from. You gotta make sure this cutout hole with the center is on top. It looks like this piece a little bit to the side. So it's gonna be inserted like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you gotta push on the these connections and just insert it all the way in. Just like that. So you got the assemblies complete. Now we're gonna go with the number 5 and number 9s. So we got number 5s here, 3 of them. And number 9s on the other plate. Once again, a little bit of pressure, not too much, in order not to break the pieces. And maybe back and forth a little bit. It looks like the back side is the front side, based on the numbers. So we got 3 of those out. And then we gotta match it with the holes. So we take the first one, and then A piece. I don't think they're marked. And we're gonna go ahead and assemble the code that is specified right here on the bottom. It's 597. So just to make sure, and the numbers match 597, so you can set up anything you want. And I'm gonna go ahead and try something else out. I'm gonna try, probably instead of 597, we'll try, let's say, 392. Let's say that, right? So we're gonna go with the 3. With the opening, put it aside. 9. Two. Have it just like this. I'm gonna move my toothpicks out. 392, and then we have to put the toothpicks in. And recommend probably cutting the toothpicks in half so you can save some. And we need, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we need 5 toothpicks to start with. I'm gonna go ahead and cut them in half. And then we're gonna do it from the back. And make sure you cover both of the holes. Insert the toothpicks from the back. This should all go all very easy. We remove that little extra brakes, and then gonna use once again the push them in a little bit further and use the surface just to push them all of them in. And it's somewhat hard, so a little bit more pressure, put it a little bit deeper inside and try again. We need to make sure that the toothpicks are not sticking out on these sides, so, and we're gonna cut them off on the other side. Make sure your fingers are out of the way. So this is my first part with the three. So I'm gonna go ahead and move to the next one. I'm gonna reuse same toothpicks. That one we decided that we're gonna go with a 9. So I'm gonna use the same ones, as it's just gonna be a little bit easier. I don't have to cut another 5 sets. I won't be able to use them on the third, but we do have toothpicks left, so. Same thing here, I'm gonna push them all the way in, kind of like one side at a time. Make sure all of them are nice and flat against the back surface. Kind of check it with your finger, and the same thing, we're just gonna chop off the portions that are sticking out. If you just break them off, make sure you use the sandpaper in order to clean off the surface. But once again, if you use the box cutter or scalpel, you should be good with just cutting them off, and the surface is gonna be clean enough and without the toothpick sticking out. If it sticks out a little bit, just make sure you clean it off. So this is our B piece. I'm gonna put it aside, and then the last one, we decided a number 2, and so it's 392. And I need 5 more. Actually, we use 10 of them, so 5 more toothpicks. Same thing here. Make sure not to puncture your fingers. This one I didn't cut very well, so I'm gonna use a new one. See, I'm missing 2. That's the flyaway ones. So I'm just gonna use one more toothpick and cut it in half. the other side. Same side that I started putting them in, which probably doesn't matter. And then once again, just push them like kind of like one side at a time. Make sure that everything is nice and flat against the surface, so we don't have anything sticking out. And then cut the toothpicks off. So that's our third piece. And now clean it off, and we gotta put it on to this assembly that we already have. And then A piece is the first one, goes three. And then we're gonna go with the to match this opening right here. So we're gonna go with A. Push onto this a little bit, onto the keys, so bring it all the way in, match the hole, A, B, C. So got these in. And then we use number 7 in order to close it up. Number 7 is right here. And then we need to make sure that these rings sit in completely. And the parts are outwards. So I'm gonna take them off for now, and then just to make sure, check everything that the surface is nice and clean, because I did see some fibers pulled out here. So I'm just gonna remove it and make sure that it's sitting far enough that it locks in like this, the rings. So we got one ring. Can I have them move it a little bit? Make sure the second one also comes in nice and clean. Do have another fiber in there, so I'm just gonna use a toothpick to push it out. And then the third one, same way, just make sure it sits in the grooves that are designed for it. And I need to apply a little bit of pressure in order to get these out. And then we put number 7 to close it all up. Oh, I apologize. Number 6 is first. I was wondering, why do I have extra space in there? So we're gonna go with number 6 is first, and make sure all the holes line up. Number 6, another number 6. And then number 7 to lock it all up in place. I'm gonna start with 1, go on to the next hole, and carefully apply apply pressure just to make sure we don't break anything off. So we got one, got a second one, third one, and fourth one. So it's nice and neat, the whole assembly. So we're done with this portion. And we switch over to the lock on the other side. We do need parts number 14, 15, and 13. So here's our little UGears component. Once again, a little bit of pressure that should get it off the locks. Don't apply too much, risking to break some pieces. So here's one. Here's a lock portion of it. Kind of try to apply the pressure equivalently across the board to get the locks off and make sure not to damage it. So we got number 14, 15. And then piece number 13 here. And then this one, get UGears. We have with the keys on the top, and we use that second bottom hole, middle hole, to put it into here. So it's nice, kind of like somewhat symmetrical. You can see, inserted there, and then we put a lock with these little screws that you can see towards the face and lock it up in place like this. So you see these screws on the front surface. Put it aside for now. Next portion, we need to pull number 12. That's our number 12 right here. Get that out. And insert it into the portion right here. And kind of wiggle your way in. Let's see. So it goes like this. The key goes on inside. And you need to make sure that this little cutout is on the side of the key. So those are a couple little pointers. And then they don't go through the holes. So it's kind of like on the outside. Here you go. And then just on the bottom, and just like that. And there's like a little stud there. That's the one that you need to put the piece on, and on the other side also. So just match them up and push them on. So you got this piece also assembled, nice and easy. Then we go with the number 10. It's a little, got a little marks on here. So gonna do it from the back. And this one with a key out, keyway towards the this key right here. And this one has to go through this little sticks and push it all the way in into the keyway. So you see it this way, nice and neat. And then we got number 11, so we got five of them right here. I'm gonna push them out. And then put them with the keyway to one side. with this key. So they're not gonna go in any other direction. So that's the only way you can put them on. And you just throw all of them five on here. It's actually five, yes. So we got number three, our number four, and number five on it. So nice little looking piece here. And we go to the last one. Looks like the last page. And then here we do need to put some toothpicks in order to lock these in place. So the ones that I cut off earlier, they're gonna be very useful. They're not gonna go all the way in, so you got one, two, the leftover pieces, three. They're gonna go in there. I'm gonna use one of the spare parts and just gonna push them in as far as I can. Well, some of them go all the way in, which is also nice. Guess it was perfect size. So got all four of them in there. I don't need to cut any spare parts out. And then we go to lock it up with to make sure everything lines up. Apologize that I was off the screen for a second. So 392 is our combination lock. So we do need to move these a little bit just to start them rolling. And they all should be on this side. So we gotta match them up with the opening. And then we can put it in. With the lock that way. Once again, your parts in the beginning, they're not gonna go in very easy, but you gotta work them out a little bit. Here we go. So nice and neat lock, all finished. And then we can lock it up. Just rotate the combination. Once again, it might take some time, or will be a little bit tough in the beginning, but once the parts settle in, it's gonna be easier and easier to rotate with every single try. So squeaky noise, just nice authentic lock, almost like metal. So as you can see, after you work them in a little bit, they're gonna go nice and smooth, smoother than they were in the beginning. So now it's nice and easy and rotating. And then you cannot open it up. And then my code, I believe, was 392. So we gotta line it up with this opening right here. First number from the back was 3. Then we got 9. It doesn't matter which way you rotate it. Rotating and just rotating to the closest. And then two. So I'm gonna go ahead and line them up with that little arrow right here, and then I should have no problem of taking it off. So as you can see, the lock works. It's kind of funny that I didn't figure it out or didn't see it at first. So if you're gonna try any other combination, doesn't work, you can rotate them separately, and said you just need to match it with this arrow right here. So you got 3, 9, 2, and then you should have no issues of taking it out. That's it. That's our combination lock. There's a little space in there. You can hide a note or two and lock it up. Make sure that nobody can access it. Here you go. Just make sure this piece gets inserted right. And you can lock it and hang it anywhere you want. That's it. If you got any questions, comments, please feel free to leave the feedback. Or you can visit our website. It's ukidztoys.com, which is UKIDZTOYS.com. There you can find all the products, and we do have 18 models at this time. Once again, any questions, just leave a comment below or email me at ukidztoys@gmail.com or visit our website, ukidztoys.com. Thank you.